So, how the hell you guys been, shavers? Today is Sunday. I'm just getting ready to go to work. It looked like it was a nice day outside, but it sure temperature wasn't. It was probably in the low 50s. So, at any rate, I figured I'd go with something that kind of warmed me up just a little bit and came up with today. We're going with PAA Pineapple Bay Rum. This stuff has one hell of a killer scent. Like I said in a previous video, I was never a Bay Rum fan until I tried this stuff, or the Atomic Age Bay Rum, because Douglas Smythe removed all the clove from it and made it amazing. So, like I said, this is a really sweet one. You get the pineapple right on top of his Atomic Age Bay Rum that I had before. We do have a matching splash. And we'll be going with the Omega Boar Professional, which we've already lathered this stuff up. This stuff kind of blew up in my lather bowl, so hopefully no issues. And then we're going back to the sexy newbie, the Wacker Allround. So this will only be the second time I've used this one. Stallion put an awesome edge on it. Pleasurable experience last time, so I expect nothing less this time. So, without further ado, get rid of the cap, dampen the face, and we'll get to lathering. So, I haven't been on here in a few days. Had a little bit of a sore throat and a cough, not COVID related, just kind of been feeling under the weather, so I would have been kind of a buzzkill to begin with, so. But I feel like I'm coming out of it now. I mean, it's still a hint of a scratchy sore throat, almost like you've been yelling. But, at the beginning of the weekend, it was just kind of kicking my butt, and all I wanted to do was just drink ice cold water all the time. So. I hear we're, supposed to reach 81 on Tuesday, so hopefully that trend continues into next weekend. I wouldn't mind getting the smoker out if the weather's cooperative. Both days this weekend that I could have, we had bad threats of rain, and both days it did rain right about the time that I would have still been cooking, so it was a wise decision not to get it out. So, we should be able to go with that. Hopefully that doesn't get dried out. I mean, this stuff, like I said, blew up in the lather bowl and looks a little bit fluffy, I guess, if you will. So, hopefully it doesn't need more water. If it does, I'll take care of it. So, I forgot the, I'll unblock the digits. There we go. Alright, so, second voyage with the beautiful Wacker all around. Here we go. This thing cuts like a dream, and as you can see, this thing is like an absolute dream. Yeah, still just taking all of that down. I'm definitely going to have to look into getting another one of these after my vacation this summer. Ew. At least it didn't open it up. Felt it getting, like, stopping, like, right in here where I usually open it up, so. Maybe I'm finally learning how to not get cut there. Switch hands. And for those of you who don't have one of these, you should definitely look into getting one. These things are absolutely amazing. Not only do they shave like a dream, but they're sexy as hell. Okay, so not bad for pass number one. I'm going to put you guys on brief hold, and I'll bring you back for the across the grain pass. So hang tight, guys. Okay, we are back for pass number two. Looking like we're doing good on time. Maybe I'll keep you along for all three passes. I don't know. I usually don't just to save time because I don't want to bore people. But any which way, we're going to go against the grain here. And this spot right here, I don't know if you guys can see it right there, it's where I opened it up a few days ago, an old zit or something. Obviously some sort of an imperfection. Looks like I might have got it, and it also looks like I might have got one weeper on first pass that I didn't notice at the beginning. But, any which way. Nothing we can't get through. Damn, I almost nicked that thing again. I think I'm just gonna get. Yeah, we're gonna. So, hopefully, you guys had a good weekend. I got to watch my number two son, not my second favorite, my number two son, Lance, my second born child, had a soccer game yesterday, and his team won 5-1. They are undefeated thus far, so they're 3-0. So, think he's got three more games, I'm pretty sure. So we'll see how things go. I don't know who the next game's against because it's just a bunch of abbreviations of letters. Other than after those, after that one, he's got two high schools from his conference, or, well, junior highs, two junior high teams from his conference, or that they'll be playing against, so we'll see how that goes. Like I said, I mean, he's a football player first. This is something he wanted to do in the spring, so if it's something he enjoys doing, fine and dandy. I mean, I'm not going to stop him. If this is something he enjoys more than football, then so be it. Be kind of hard, but because I know he's a really good football player. But at the same time, you want your kids to do what they enjoy doing. So, all right, now the dreaded mustache. Well, let's get that spot first. I think I'm going to count my blessings where we're at. Didn't cut myself there. So I'll bring you back. We'll do the across the grain on the cheeks, and we'll get out of here. So hang tight for just a moment, and I will be, like I said, right back. Okay, we're back. I thought I was about to get timed out, so I probably wasn't anywhere near, but at the same time, I always worry about that, so... to lose a hair on this brush, maybe. I may have to get another one of these. This thing is starting to just feel like a dream the way it, the brush works anyway, but at the same time, I have lost quite a few hairs on it, so I don't know if that's normal. For those of you who use a lot of boar brushes, let me know. I mean, it doesn't seem like it's lost much, but it, I mean, I bet you it's probably lost 10 or 15 hairs since I got the thing back in October, which I probably shaved with it about 25 times, maybe. So, I mean, I guess if that's normal, then no cause for concern. But, alright, so, just have to clean up the earlobes a little bit. I always seem to wipe that shit away right where I need to start the blade in there. Okay. Alright, so, going across the grain, and then we'll take care of whatever missing stuff on the neck. Alright, here we go. Now with this point on this thing, I'm being real careful. It's got a Spanish point, so it's got a deceiving looking end, if you will, where you think it might have a pretty forgiving end on it, if you will. But right in here, because of the curves, I'm afraid that that thing's going to nick and slice my lip open, so I'm just going to... go against the grain right there. Clean the blade off. We'll get what we can of the mustache. Get the neck. Yeah, real smooth. Okay, on to the other side. So if I get the weather to start cooperating with me, I've got a lot of dirt to get dropped off in my backyard. It's got like one of these and then like this in the spots. And so a few years ago, we dug a big trench and I buried a sump pump in order to get water out of my backyard. But at the same time, it's become kind of unsightly because of the fact that it's so uneven. When we moved in here, it was a really dry summer, so we didn't realize what kind of trouble we were in for whenever we'd get a whole bunch of rain. So the following summer, we definitely found out what the issue was going to be. But so now I've buried the sump pump. We've got that in place. Now it's just a matter of trying to even it out in the backyard so that everything is a lot more even looking, if you will. So I'm probably going to have like probably 30 yards worth of dirt dropped off and then have to roll it, use the tamponers to try and even out, because I've probably got about 3 foot from the lowest point to where average part of my yard is. So if you can imagine, I might have to show you guys some pictures sometime. Probably won't be tomorrow. Maybe it'll be after I start getting the dirt. I'll get a before and after picture for you. So, any which way, I'm going to put you guys on hold and we'll be right back with the post-shave. Okay, we're back. I just basically rinsed up real good. I do have the Thayer's Witch Hazel. Throw a quick splash of that on. Beautimus. Alright, the unscented balm. Put some of this on. This junk always gets caught in my silicone ring, so. Whoa, damn, that came on pretty damn thick. Ugh. Guess I just didn't rub it in well enough. There we go. Okay, so I've done this on a demo to teach others, and I've kind of in a way taught myself. This stuff here, the way these bottles were designed, cover it upside down, let it burp like so, cover it back up, flip it back over. The burn with this stuff, no joke. My skin wanted to yell like Kevin from Home Alone, but my pride wouldn't let it. So. Alright, so any which way, what a great day. Great shave. No issues. I did get that one spot, like I said, right here, that had been getting it. I don't know why it hasn't healed, but any which way. Today we went with the sexy Wacker Allround. It is a sexy razor. Damn. Stallion, you were right. Worth every penny. And stars, if you will, today were PAA's Pineapple Bay Rum. The stuff, great shit, okay? It's, for those of you who are contemplating on Bay Rum, who were turned off by clove, give this stuff a chance. This stuff is a little sweeter than the Atomic Age. If you need something to kind of mellow out even the bay, if you will, it's perfect. I mean, obviously it's not my one top favorite scent, but it's up there. It's very nice, very pleasant. So, like I said, we went with the Wacker Allround, the Omega Boar Professional, and PAA's Pineapple Bay Rum. So, you guys have a great day, night, whenever. I will catch you guys again soon, hopefully tomorrow if I got time before I head to work. Keep your shaves clean, keep them wet. Later, guys.